How's the bacon, did you say?
It's Duta! Oh, what a fantastic hit!
Roy Keane on Haaland.
Here's Sancho.
Aguero! Oh, I swear you'll never see anything like this ever again!
Hello and welcome to the Prawn Sandwich Podcast, Season 3, Episode 3. I'm Nathan Cupid and I am joined by Jamie Jackson.
Hello.
And Dylan McKenzie.
Hello.
Jim's episode this week, but before we get into that, we'll just have a quick recap about last week. Massive thank you to Stephen Turnbull from T7 Clothing for coming on. He's done wonders with us on social media and things like that. It's kind of boomed since he's came on, hasn't it?
I was
nice and well.
Good having him on. Nice to put a face to the name finally.
About it really, Jamie, just take over, mate.
Fair enough. This week is like the first part of a series we're going to do where we've all started Football Manager saves at the same time, and we're going to review them. It's kind of stemmed off the back of first lockdown when the three of us all done a network save, and we're up to like 3:30, 4 a.m. in the morning because nobody had any work to go do or anything. And we wish we'd done it back then, but it was like an afterthought. So
I'd love to be able to go back and do that one, like,
all over again. Like,
I'd love to just go back and just look over the, because it was like 2.5 seasons we did, wasn't it? Like, just go back and document it all.
But there was absolutely no way we could manage that this time around doing a network save. Nate's still working in that, and it just would never happen. So we've all started our own saves. And we're doing different versions of the game and different databases and stuff. So I'm doing the FM20 and database for the 99-2000 season, which was created by the lads at the FM, what was it called? Bear with us. The FM Retro Group on Twitter. So big shout out to them for spending months putting this together, because it's unreal once you get into it and that the amount of time that's spent into it. What are you doing, Dil? What version of the game?
Just an old game, just the new game, Football Manager 21. So, choose to make another version of that.
And Nath.
I'm doing the same database as you, Jamie, mate.
Same database as me. Right, sound. I'll start off with me then. Originally, I was going to go Fiorentina on this and then try and finally win the Serie A with Gabriel Batistuta. In the side, and then at the last minute changed my mind and went Parma. So again, though, a team that didn't win the league in the 90s that maybe probably should, hence why I've got the Parma top on today from that season as well. Loaded it up, got started, had a look at the squad and was like oofed. The squad was unreal. Crespo, Taram, Buffon, Cannavaro, Dino Baggio, Ariel Ortega, which I totally forgot about that side. The Brazilian Amoroso that moved to Dortmund.
Yeah.
A couple of seasons after that he was in. So, like, my starting 11 was absolutely mint to start with. But my initial finances and budget was only like 26 million in the bank. And the board only given us like 6.7 million. Before I'd even started this save, I had an idea in my head that I wanted to sign Ronaldinho from Gremio. Like, that was what I was going to build this entire save on. And then, you know, the rules in Italy where you can only sign 2 non-EU players each season.
Yeah.
Quarter had already been filled. So I couldn't even sign him. And the players that had already been filled by was George Bolano, who was like a 22-year-old Colombian midfielder. He was cack. And Johnny A. Montano, who's another Colombian attacking mid, who was only 16-year-old. So totally wasted the non-EU allowance that was allowed. So that totally like ruined my plans straight away. No Ronaldinho.
You're not trying to sell them? Sign him?
Nah, it doesn't work like that because you've already used them to sign it, because I've tried that before in a different save. Right, but I still needed to generate some money anyway. Although I was happy with my side, I still wanted a defensive midfielder. Because the formation I opted to play was a 4-4-2, but a diamond with wing backs, basically playing as low lying wingers. So originally I would have been playing a 4-2-3-1, but the Ronaldinho thing just totally ruined everything for us. I sold Mario Stanic to Chelsea for 14 million. So nice little tie-in with actual real life there as well.
Mario Stanic.
Luigi Sarto sold into Lyon. A few reserve players are sold. What was really annoying was Jorge Bolano is so rubbish. Like, he's not going to get anywhere near the first team. So, like, I loaned him out. So, that non-EU thing just annoying us every step of the way. Signed Mark Van Bommel from PSV, 7 mil.
Nice.
Deep-lying playmaker. Beat Man U to the signing of him as well, which was quite nice. I got Andrea Pirlo on loan from Inter, just as a backup attacking midfielder. Carles Puyol, 550 grand. That was his release clause because he was only like 20 year old or something. So that's cover for right back and centre half. Antonio Cassano from Bari.
What a player.
16 year old or something. And Fabian O'Neill, can you mind him? Uruguayan attacking midfielder.
Yeah.
He was pure sought after on the game and managed to get him for 850 grand, like plus add ons and that. And his like attributes on it are unreal. Got it from Cagliari. So that was my transfers in anyway. What was really like with it being like a bit of a mad database, with it being like 99 and 2000, noticing the other transfers that were going on. So here's just a list of some like pure random transfers that popped up. Nigel Winterburn from Arsenal to PSG. Phil Neville on loan to Udinese.
Oofed.
And Blackburn had just been relegated to the Championship that season. So like loads of their players were sought after on the game. Jason Wilcox moved to Leicester for 8.75 mil.
That's cheap. That's cheap for a good talent.
And Callum Davidson moved to Wolves for 4.3 million.
Jesus.
I made us think Blackburn would be a mint save on that game. You could generate loads of coin.
Oh, yeah.
Because they've still got Janssen and Duff and David Dunham. Anyways, back to Palmer. Obviously, I don't know if you do it, but I just, friendlies, I just set my assistant to manage friendlies. I can't be asking for all of them.
Yeah.
So, through the friendlies, beat some team called PSMS Medan 4-1, lost to Sampdoria 1-0, and then I beat Como, Cesena 3-0 apiece, and then won 1-0 against Olympiacos. And my main starting 11 that I wanted to have would have been Buffon in goal. He's my captain as well. Taram and Cannavaro at centre-half. Vanoli, left wing-back. Diego Fuser, right wing-back. Alain Boghossian, defensive mid, and then Van Bommel and Baggio in centre mid. Ariel Ortega in cam with Hernan Crespo and Amoroso up top. And I thought I definitely got a good chance of winning the league here. So that was basically pre-season. So my first my fixture list, when I looked at that, I had an opening game away to Fiorentina. Then I was at home to Juve. Then away to Roma. Then at home to Winter.
Jesus.
What a minging four games to open with.
So what's your goal? Win the league. That's why this what the save is.
Challenge for the Serie A is what the board want. But my goal is to win the league with Parma. That's my...
I've still got yours. I've sacked the board.
Nah, that's what I want to do. Like, that's win the league with Parma.
That's it, set the board
in Italy,
they'll have you.
In the 2 hours, I'll be dead. Shot.
But during pre-season, Buffon got injured for like 4 weeks and my reserve keeper's absolutely crap. And I'm not going out and buying a keeper. It was fitting time anyway to start the first game. I'll just jump to the first game, which was away to Fiorentina, 25th of August. There's a starting 11 that I just listed off there. What really annoyed us was the squad numbers were wrong for Fiorentina. Like, I noticed when I come to, you know, when you pick your squad numbers, none of the players were assigned squad numbers at all. So I went through them. Like, I Googled on my phone, like, what Palmer squad numbers were that season, so I could put the proper ones in.
Love it.
But then when I come up against Fiorentina, come up Batistuta 12, I was like, nah. I'm raging with this. And it was in the game, went 1-0 up early on. Crespo absolutely pummeled them. It was just chances just weren't being converted. And then Batistuta equalised just before half time. But I thought, nah, like, my team is better than I realised on this. Continued to battle them. Finished 3-1 to Fiorentina. Batistuta hat trick.
Batty goal, man.
I had 20... tried to sign Batty goal.
I haven't got the coin. It's worth like 27 mil.
So what's your transfer budget?
Oh, yeah.
Initially, it was like 6.7. And then when I sold Stanic, like for like 14 mil. And then a few bits and pieces after I'd bought Van Bommel for 7 and then other than that. It's kicking around about the 10 mark now. But I want to sign Ronaldinho the following season. So
I save a bit of money.
Keep the money aside because I reckon I could get him for about 10 mil. There's only like 18 on it.
It'd have been worth not signing Van Bommel for Batty Goldman.
I still wouldn't have been able to afford him.
I suppose maybe being like 20 odd million.
Damiano Tomasi like was on the transfer list from Roma for like 600 grand, but his attributes on it were awful. And I just didn't want to fill a place in the squad with him because of pure love for the man.
That's a tick in the con list for the database then, because Tomasi's me.
I had a look at the stats for that Fiorentina game. I had 25 shots and 16 on target, only scored one. And Batistuta scored his hat-trick and there was 9 shots on target and I think 7 of them were for him. From 7 shots on target. And so not the best of starts. And then second game, home to Juventus. I kept the exact same starting 11. And match kicked off, went 1-0 down early on. I'm going to try and pronounce this name. I've not heard of him before. Guglielm Pietro. He put Juventus 1-0 up. Crespo equalised. Fabio Cannavaro, who I've got on the back of this top, put us 2-1 up. And then Crespo got a third.
Nice.
So finished 3-1. Again, inconsistent in the squad numbers. Del Piero, he was like number 14 or something.
Ah, oh, that'd do better.
They were all wrong. Oh, just wait until I get into the Roma team. Roma, yeah, Roma match in the next episode in the series. But yeah, so lost my first game 3-1, won my second game 3-1, and was 10th after two games, and that was it.
Just doing 2 months. That sounds right though. Tough start.
You get pure loss just like searching for like through different clubs and like just to see the players like players on there and who they're real. Like Steve McManaman's on the transfer list like right at the start, even though he's just signed for Real Madrid.
Fucking that man.
His things are actually like, class as well.
Just like if you go back in like. If listeners go back onto like the 907 million episodes that we did in series one, we've covered Italy, but like how good was that Parma side? Like there was a solid 6 years where they had an influx of good players coming in and leaving, like Zola and Asprilla, like the very start, and then like towards the back end of the decade, like Crespo and all that. Like they had a good side. It's a shame how they never won a league, you know what I mean?
Like in the midst of all them mint players that they had, I totally forgot that they had Ariel Ortega.
Well, yeah, exactly.
I totally forgot that he moved there. And like this is the season Verona's just moved to Lazio, so Ortega's the replacement for Veron. But that it was annoying, right? I put that Boghossian on the transfer list because they had loads of interest from like Barca and Real Madrid and that. And I thought, I'll definitely get some more money for him and like just buy someone I'd rather have.
Yeah.
So I started offering them about, none of them would make offers. It was like, they were just like cock-teasing us with interest. But I think it's going to be hard to generate money in Serie A on this one.
Yeah.
Because there's just not that much money. There's not going to be that much money coming in. So I reckon I'll have to get to the end of the season and then maybe try and sell Boghossian again or maybe sell a Turam or something.
Sorry, mate. We've got a couple of years till Calciopoli kicks in, so you might get a bunk to win the league.
Imagine that. Imagine if that's in the database. For I think when I was looking at the other, because Fiorentina were top after two games, they won their other game. Batistuta scored like another hat trick or something.
Yeah.
He's absolutely insane on this game.
Yeah, you've just got a kind of vibe that they've kind of programmed him to be a god.
And then, I've got Inter coming up, and Inter have Vieri and Ronaldo in their side. Ronaldo's like constant link with Man U on it as well.
Yeah.
I hope that actually happens.
So you can win the league.
So I don't have to worry about him.
Yeah, I've done like Crespo, like keeps up with them.
He will. Earnings class.
He's pure good on this. His attributes are unreal. He's only like 22 on it and all.
Yeah.
Amoroso, he's like in those Fiorentina and the Juventus games doing absolutely nicks. It was like 6.4 rating or something for both of them. Van Bommel's been good. Van Bommel like got good ratings in those first couple of games, but it's going to take a lot of like getting past Cannavaro, Taram and Buffon, I hope.
Yeah,
unless you buy a Stewart.
Unless you're Batistuta. But yeah, I mean, I mentioned them before, but the FM Retro Group on Twitter, if you like, check them out, if you're listening and you want to have a look at this database, they've done a great job like putting it together, because it must be an absolute graft, like the amount of information that's gone in. It's absurd.
So but, promising start.
Promising start. Promising start. Happy with the performance of Crespo and my main signing, Van Bommel. The other ones, like the other ones I've only just brought off the bench in these first two games, like O'Neill, Perlo, Puyol, they've just got a few minutes off the bench, so I haven't had the chance to do anything. I haven't got much squad depth on the fullback positions. It's like Bonavaro, who can cover both sides, and Serena, who can cover both sides as well, but they're both old. Like, there's not much about them compared to Vanoli and Fuser.
Yeah.
I can switch to a flat back four and, like, play Taram or Puyol at right back as well, though.
That's all right, then.
Yeah.
Have you got your UEFA Cup to look forward to as well that season?
No, I don't think I have. I think I should have, but...
European tournament.
Yeah, I don't seem to be in Europe at all. I'm sure Palmer had finished second the season before, so I don't know. I don't know what's happened. It's like there's a few inconsistencies like in it that I've noticed.
Yeah,
it might not be included from the start. Sometimes you can click off that, can't you, and stuff.
Yeah, so I've maybe clicked something I did notice when I downloaded the database, because there was loads of different files. There was one that said like old UEFA rules. So if I've loaded that, then that's maybe... like done something to I don't know,
like a qualifier or something.
Yeah, I just as I say, my target is for like this save. The purpose for this save is to win the league. Anything else is just a bonus, but win the league and fulfill the prophecy that never was. I'm not in the league.
Love it.
But I'm happy to move on to Dylan now if you haven't got any more questions about that.
Yeah, can do.
Yeah.
Right, short but sweet. If anyone listening played the 21 game, for our save, we said we'd do the first 2 months of a save, so July and August, but because of COVID, you start on the 11th of August on the new game. So the tale of the story, lads, is when we both said we were all going to do it, I said I was going to go Sunderland. I actually did all the way to March, and then sacked it off. Couldn't be arsed anymore. Wasn't enjoying it.
Yeah.
Because of, I don't know, I struggled to play Footy Manager with Sunderland sometimes if they're pissing me off in real life.
I know what you mean.
Oh, it's relatable.
And then I downloaded the 2006 database and I started Sunderland on that. I thought, I'll document that. And then I sacked it off as well. And I didn't sack up playing that. But I thought, I need to do something decent for this. And I went back to 21 and found a team that is a rebuilding job like Sunderland. And I thought, I'm going to go at this. I could totally fail and be shipped out and not have a job. But if I can do something, if try and do this. So I have started a save in Segunda Division B.
I know who this is.
Deportivo La Coruña.
Yes.
Get in.
Love that. Get in. That's quality.
I'm gonna try and get my main goal is to get Deportivo back to La Liga. That's my main goal.
Absolutely love that.
Loads of time for that.
The goal set by the board is I have to win Division B1 to get to the second division in Spain. I have to win the league. But when I get to the second division, I just have to stay mid-table for like 3 years.
Yeah.
But obviously, I'm hoping not to do that. But the main stumbling block is like real life. Because of where they're at and where they are now, they're absolutely ruined financially. So my budget was a million euros, but I had no wage budget. So to get anyone in, I had to adjust it all. So, So like I looked at the squad, and you know, lads, know when you start like games like this, you don't know anyone. That's kind of fun about it. You don't know the players. I only really knew Diego Roland, the forward, and he's like my star player on it. But I looked at the squad, and overall, I'm playing a 4-2-3-1, but narrow, so like no wingers. So I'm playing three cams. Behind the forward. So to like generate a bit of funds back at the club, I pretty much just sold every winger that I had in the first team. So that was, it was, I don't even know the armor. where's the first one going? That's in September. Basically, the first thing I found out was this save. This thing with this save that's going to be hard for me for the first two episodes of this is there's only 18 teams in the league. 10 teams in the league. So I only play 18 games.
No.
Start till mid October. I'm just going to say it now.
Oh, fair enough. I done a save on CMO 102 with Compostela, and they started in like the Segunda B or whatever it is, and it was something like four different leagues,
right?
Like, and is it not like that now?
It's Segunda Division B1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I think if you win B1, you must go into it somehow.
Back then, it was like a top four, and if you finished in the top four, you qualified for playoffs. And then you went into playoffs against all the other teams.
Whoa.
So the season didn't finish till like June or something. And that was
I think that's what happens. Yeah. But I'm just going to try and get through the league first and see where it takes us. I looked at the squad and I thought, right, I'll go 4-2-3-1. Put my scout straight out for cams. Just thought, get a few in. So I've got rotation. Put my wingers on the transfer list. And so the first few days, thought I'll do the inter-squad friendly. Some little mug of a youthy hacks down Diego Roland. He's out for 7 weeks. 4 days in the job, my star player. And the only thing that annoyed me is I don't want to sell him, but he's worth like £6 million euros, and Everton and Newcastle want him. So if he can generate money, I might have to sell him for the sake of the club. Now he's been hacked down, it's just not going to happen.
FM loves doing that to you, like, doesn't it?
Huh?
FM, this game just loves doing that to you.
Oh, like,
it was always. By a mile. I was injured for 7 weeks.
Always.
So, 15th of August, 4 days in the job, my first signing arrives. Centre-back Nicolò Armini on loan from Lazio. I know I raved about him on the last game, 20. He was decent for Sunderland, so I thought I'm going to try and get him back in, see what he's like. But another good thing, just signed a new contract at Lazio. So it's like on the game, if you try to buy him, they ask you straight up for like 60 million. So I'm hoping he's just going to be pure stalwart in a shit division so I don't concede many.
Yeah.
First bit of news, Nathan Fugenbauer, you've played 21. Nothing, there's no real signings on it because of COVID. Stick with like budgets, so like teams like Arsenal, Man United, that they don't really make any signings. So the only worthy bit of news that's really happened in the short end of the August month for me is Guti's just joined Real Madrid as assistant manager.
Oh, nice.
I was like, oh, pod favourite.
That's what I was going to ask you. Like, see, when the games like that, obviously, do you not try and get, like, staff members in that used to play for the club to try and get fans on your side? Because that's something I always do.
Well, I was going to, and then I had, like, a decent-sized staff. And, you again, budget, you've got nothing. So the only coaching member I've got is ex-Mexico captain Rafa Marquez, came in as a coach.
Oh!
Yeah, Dave.
Get his boots back on.
Oh, definitely. I was hoping to see like a Walter Pandiani or something, but nah, Marquez tops that.
Teddy Sharing, Randy Cole didn't want to come to the northwest of Spain, didn't want to relocate, so.
Typical British attitude, that.
Oh, I was like, what?
Who were effort that from Teddy, like. Maybe Teddy's heard that you've offered Andy a job, and Andy's heard that you've offered Teddy a job, and they've gone, oh, well, no, I'm not working there.
Well, both on my staff in the Sunderland save that I had, so maybe.
They've maybe buried the hatchet.
Yeah, but no. First signing made. And then my second friendly was my last game in August. For some reason, in these COVID times, Sheffield Wednesday made the trip to Coruña.
No,
love it.
Beat us 1-0. Similar to you saying, Jay, though, I absolutely hammered them. But because I had Diego rolling out, I had 34-year-old Miku up top, and like I couldn't finish anything. I had about 19 shots. And like I say, it's a friendly, so I'm not too arse, and I was playing a new system, but still a bit shit when you think, oh, crap, I've lost it. But then I was also trying to flip it and thinking, I am in Secunda B. I can't really expect much from these players.
I'd be cancelling a couple of friendlies that they've got arranged against like better sides and just arranging some like proper naff non-league Spanish sides.
I haven't really got many. They're all against lower division Spain sides in other divisions. And then the only real one I've got, the last friendly before the first game of season, is Real Madrid B.
All right.
So I'm not too bothered at the minute. But so hard to get players in. So I thought I'll smash the loan market. And the final days of August, 25th of August, two signings made. Felix Nmecha joins from Man City on a season-long loan.
Nice.
Yes, that is my favourite signing on the past two Football Manager games.
Just that, only had to pay his wages, just had to like put my budget. I pretty much just put my budget to zero funds and all wages so I could just get loans and freeze. And then Harvey White joined from Spurs as a deep line playmaker option. Because when I joined, the thing I looked at as well is I only had three centre mids on the book. And the thing that's panicking is a bit, one of them's wanted by Las Palmas in the division above us. So I'm shit, I'm like, off. They bid, he's got a young lad called Agbo. So I don't think he's going to join. So at the minute, I'm looking for a striker. And then the last bit of news for my save before I went off on the 27th of August. Remember your Brentford save on the last game, Nate, when we're all together?
Yes.
And you had Moa.
Yes.
He signed for Norwich for 80k. I'd put a bid in as well. And he rejected me because he wanted like quite a bit of money.
Yeah.
Because I don't have any. But Norwich shipped him right on the loan list. So a day after he rejected us, I just put a bid in for loan and he came straight away.
Get in.
So my starting lineup pretty much is, you won't know them, but I'm going to keep his name. Centre-halves of Bergantinos and Armini. Right-back's name is Valin. He's quite decent. He's got good wing-back stats. Left wing-back, just for the name of loving it, Hector Hernandez.
Nice.
Love it.
Aye. Nearly made him captain because of that, but apparently Bergantinos has been there for 12 years. This is another thing, my first for Footy Manager, lads, which will be in the next show, but my next fixture is a testimonial. I've never had that in Footy Manager.
Nice. Never had that.
Bergantinos is testimonial.
Nice. Oh, I love that.
And I went on his history, and he's been at the club for about 12 years. He only had one loan. I think it was Genoa, but yeah, I was like, oh, fair enough.
That's quality, that.
Oh, I love that.
I've definitely made friendlies, and in my own head, narrative said there were testimonials when I was younger.
I was quite happy with it. I was like, oh, I love that. Yeah. Two centre mids of Agbo and Borges, and then at the minute, the cams of a lad called Gonzalez, and then Nemecha and Moa behind at the minute, Miku. But I think the saving grace for the season not start until October is Roland will be back.
Yeah, aye.
As long as no bids come in for him, I should be sound.
I don't mind long injuries if it's in pre-season. As long as they're back before the season starts, I don't mind it.
It's just when he got injured, I hadn't really looked at my fixtures because that was just like my first few days and I just did the squad friendly.
Yeah.
And I was like 7 weeks, I was like, oh, piss off. And then it was like our first game locked up October. It's like, oh, thank God for that. Like, he's got time to like recover at least.
That buys you time.
Well, absolutely.
But yeah, I've done half of September like at home, I haven't but some decent news in the early September for the next show.
Loving that Deportivo.
Yeah, absolutely.
I've been on the hunt for Deportivo shirts on eBay and that as well. Like I found a couple, so that's weird.
I was looking last night after I started the same.
Depending on what year you want, you can get some quite cheap. Like,
I'm gonna see who's mint for us because I might get these seasons. If one of them does all right for us,
love it.
Agbo's flying.
That's cool.
That's pretty much it for me. Nothing much on games, but yeah. Deportivo.
I must admit, like, one of the main attractions for getting FM21 was for that. Like, if I was to get it, which I'm not, but if I was, like, was the thought of having a Deportivo save and trying to build them back up to former glories. Because they had a pure, like, Palmer-esque. So, well, they actually won the league, didn't they?
Yeah,
they did. Deportivo won the league with Roy Mackay and Pandiani, Jalminia and that. They had some mint players.
It was between them and on this game, Palermo back in Serie C, so you don't have to download the database. So I was between them two, but I thought I'm gonna go with Deportivo. I like Spanish football, so
love that.
I've got loads of time for that Deportivo league proper. loads of time for it.
It's a pure pest because we aren't actually telling each other about it in our group chat, which we talk about for every day.
you'll do something like. You do something really good that you're like genuinely excited about. You're like, I can't. Like, I've got to tell the lads.
I just looked at my notes. Two strikers that rejected me after Roland's. I thought, I got to Brazil. Like, I'll find something in there. Both available for loans if wanted because their season's not on, but both said absolutely no chance. Carlos Tevez. And ex Hull City striker Abel Hernandez. I thought I was going to get him. I thought he would generally come, and he didn't.
That's class.
over to you, Nath.
I'm playing the same database as Jamie, but I'm not in Italy. I decided to go in the Premier League, and after. There's so many teams I wanted to go, but I could I decided to flip a coin, and I flipped between Aston Villa and Leicester City. Flipped a coin, and it landed on Aston Villa. So I went Aston Villa. But a transfer budget of £3 million, board expectation, a top half finish, a quarter final place in the FA Cup, and a quarter final place in the Intertoto Cup.
They're asking a lot, aren't they?
Aston Villa weren't bothered about the League Cup. They were more bothered about the Intertoto Cup. So I was like, right, okay, fine, fair enough. To be honest with you, as far as like transfers and that go, I got my business done straight away. Like, when I play Football Manager, I have a look at the squad. Without even playing friendlies or anything, I look at the squad and then look at ratings and all that. I just get my business done. But because this is 99-2000, you kind of like know the players. So I just went straight into the squad and immediately got rid of players that I just generally don't like. My transfers out. I sold Steve Stone to Burnley for £425,000. Sold Colin Calderwood to Wolves for £325,000. I loaned out Darren Byfield to Walsall. Steve Watson went to West Ham for £3 million.
Oof. Get the money.
Ooh, that's a decent wedge.
Oh, this one. And the board, actually, the board and the fans were generally disappointed with this one. Like, I've got a massive red warning about it, and they still haven't forgiven us for it. I sold Stan Collymore to Leon for £4.3 million. And they were the board were genuinely unhappy with me.
Well, they have not just signed him.
No, he's been there 2 seasons.
No. Oh, fucking then.
That's a bit of coin. That's a bit of coin brought in there, though.
Oh, yeah. Straight away. I was going to try and sell Gareth Southgate because I'm just... You know what I mean? But I kind of thought, no. To be fair, I mean, he was a good defender. Bad manager, but a good defender. So I'll keep him.
Don't put him on pens.
Well, I don't, mate. So transfers in. I'll just get my transfers out the way. So...
Kevin Davies.
No. Although I did look. I tried to get Kevin Davies and I tried to get James Beattie from Southampton, but they were having none of it. They weren't coming. I made an offer for Teddy Sheringham on loan, but he'd rather go on loan to Udinese in Italy. So I was like, well, fair enough. So the deals I actually did get done, I signed Olof Melberg for £63,000 from Real Santander.
That's nice. How old are you on that?
22, something like that. 22, 23.
Yeah, fair enough.
Well, like I say, I only had 2 centre-backs. Once I'd sold Calderwood, that was it. I had Southgate and Hugo Ehiog as centre-back, so I kind of thought I'll get 2 centre-backs in as cover. So £63,000 for Olof Melberg was good. I got David May on loan from Manchester United.
Of course you did.
That's right, David May.
And he starts.
He does start, yes. I signed Michael Reisiger from Barcelona for £205,000. Oh, I was happy with that one.
Oh, nice. Full Dutch international at the time.
Nice.
I got Wesley Schneider from Ajax for £3.4 million.
Was he 16-year-old or something there?
17, mate.
Oofed.
Oh, he's mint. I signed David Connolly from Feyenoord for £1.8 million.
Woo-hoo. You are doing some business here.
I always do business, mate. I don't need a Land Rover with the window down in transfer windows like Harry Redknapp. No, get my business done. And I don't even know why I did it. I think I did this one just for sheer banter, but I signed a 15-year-old Dean Ashton on a free from Crewe. So he's in the reserves. So hopefully... But to be fair to him, he's got a nice little partnership with Darius Vassell in the reserves. So hopefully that's something to look forward to. Other transfers. There wasn't really much. Robert Pires signed for Arsenal, £1.3 million. Flavio Conceição joined Liverpool for £19 million. So I was like, "Woof, that's a deal." John Dahl Thomason signed for Man United for £11.25 million. And sticking with Jamie's, Nigel Winterburn went on loan to Espanyol. So Nigel Winterburn's quite a sought after player in this database.
You think?
Actually, what's going on?
I have no idea. Whoever made the database must quite clearly be a Nigel Winterburn fan, or Nigel Winterburn's made it himself. So, like I say, friendlies, as far as friendlies go, I only had 2 because the Inter Toto Cup was like right at the start, so, and there was quite a lot of games. So I've only played 2 friendlies, but my assistant did them. So I beat Olympiacos 1-0. A goal from Lee Hendry.
I love you're in that.
Must have been a worldie.
I love you're in the Toto Cup.
And I beat Hart in a friendly as well. That was another 1-0. A goal from Benito Carbone. So that must have been a worldie as well.
Oh, nice. Fan of the pod, Benito Carboni.
Yeah, he is.
Wait, it was until it got deleted.
I tried to delete it off Instagram. He was a fan.
He was a massive
fan. Back on Instagram now.
So then straight into the Intertoto Cup. So I forgot that every round in the Intertoto Cup was a two-leg system. I thought it was just a one game through, but no, it's a two-leg system. So like, this is absolutely what this, as well as the season, it's such a long period. But anyways, first round, I was drew against Racing FC Luxembourg. Won the first leg 5-0. Two goals from Alan Thompson and a hat-trick from Super Dion Dublin.
What's your start 11?
My start 11, Brother Lee, well, I've gone into that info league games, but...
Because
I just kind of... For the Intertoto Cup, I just kind of like just suggested. I just let my assistant pick the 11s for the Intertoto.
It's a bit like a pre-season, those early rounds of the Intertoto.
Yeah, like I still managed it, but like as far as picking the 11s, I just let my assistant pick them because I thought it's just the Intertoto Cup. I thought I was going to absolutely smash it, to be fair. And then I won the second leg 3-0. Got a Barry. Oh, my David Beckham pitch has fallen. Got a Barry scored. And then Hugo Ehiog got a brace. So we went through to the second round.
Yeah, and I got Drew
against Hearts. So we already had history with them from the friendly. So I won the first leg 2-1 away. Another brace from Dion Dublin.
Machines.
Juanjo or something scored for Hearts. And then I won the second leg 2-0. Benito Carbone and Paul Merson with the goals.
Merson.
Yeah.
A midfield two of Merson, Barry.
And then I went into the third round and played AEK Larnacus. Won 3-0, Dublin hat-trick. And then the second leg, I won 1-0. And that was Steve Watson. He scored that goal just before I sold him. And then I got to the quarterfinals. So I've already met the board's expectations.
You're still only in the quarters, and you've
played. Yes. And then, he's all in August.
Oh, yeah, it's not pre-season.
Wow.
And then I got Drew against Liverpool in the quarter final.
Oh, yeah.
I lost the first leg in extra time, 2-1. Smeeter scored 2, and my goal came from Southgate. And then I lost the second leg 1-0, Michael Owen. So I got knocked out at the quarterfinal stage, but I was happy because I met the board's expectations.
You got the tick.
Third place was Liverpool. Liverpool came third. They beat Dundee 3-1 to finish third. And then the winners were Juventus. They beat Hamburg 2-1. The top goal scorers for that Intertoto Cup tournament, Michael Owen finished top goal scorer with 10. Hamburg's Anthony Yeboah got 9.
Nice.
And PSV's Ruud van Nistelrooy got 8. So I'd seen that van Nistelrooy had scored 8 and was like, I'm going to sign him. So I was like, I'll give you £8 million for him. They came back like, no, we want 30 million. So I was like, have a nice day, lads. I'll stick with Dion. And then obviously, before the Premier League season starts, there's always the Charity Shield, Arsenal versus Man United. Arsenal won 3-1. Pires got 1 and Parler got 2. And Wes Brown scored for Man United. But the opening weekend came. So what I've been doing is I've been writing like significant or like quite like high score lines in other games. So weekend, Leeds beat Leicester 6-0. Man United beat Wimbledon 5-2. Arsenal beat Southampton 5-1. And Bradford beat Sheffield Wednesday 7-0.
Wow.
Yo, mate. So when I'd signed David Connolly, obviously it went into the press and that, and the press had asked Chelsea manager Gianluca Vialli, like, what his thoughts were on me signing David Connolly from Feyenoord. And his reply was, there's a lack of opportunities being made to young English talent in the Premier League. So then for his first game of the season, he fielded an 11 with no English players in.
So I was like, you get a, you were diplomatical.
I was like, hold on a minute, Luca. You know, if you're gonna shoot the king, you better hit the king, you know what I mean? Like, so first game of the season, at home at Villa Park against Spurs. I played a 4-4-2, but like a tight diamond, so that they didn't really want wingers. I just kind of go for, I think, solidarity in the middle, and I've got Alan Wright and Risinger that can bomb up and down the wing. So my 11 was Peter Enkelman in goals because David James got injured. I had a flat back four of Michael Risinger, Gareth Southgate, Hugo Ehiog and Alan Wright. The right side of the diamond was Merson. Left side of the diamond was Alan Thompson. Gareth Barry in Holding and Lee Hendry in Cam. And I had Dion Dublin and Benito Carboni in a false nine. And Dion Dublin's obviously my captain.
Obviously. That was
right off Southgate. And I was absolutely all over them. Like, all over them. I ended up finishing the game with 62% possession. Like, I absolutely wiped the floor with them, but I got beat 2-1. Dion scored a penalty and David Ginola scored a brace. So I was like, I'm going to lose. I'll happily lose to someone beautiful, you know what I mean?
He's unreal on that database, Ginola.
Oh, both of them were free kicks. Like 40-yard free kick, like top bins. I was like, oh man, I've got Peter Enkelman in nets, man. You can't be doing that. And then I don't know, like, what, obviously it's not the same for you, but I've never known. I can't remember, like, as a kid, like, how often the Premier League fixtures were coming. But on this database, it seems to be like Saturday, Tuesday, Saturday, Tuesday. So, like, there's I've played 5 league games already from pre season. The games just come thick and fast. I'm just trying to keep on top of it.
Well, I think because the league games start on that database for the English league on like the 7th of August.
Yeah.
And there was definitely a game. That actual season, we played in real life, we played Chelsea on the opening day of the season. Then we played Watford 4 days later. Then we played Arsenal. And I think we played Leeds. 5 games in the August that season sounds about right, to be fair.
They were coming thick and fast. Like. The second league game at home again to Coventry City.
Derby.
So kind of similar. I flipped the 11 about a bit. So I put David James back in nets. Risinger right back, Ekiog and Southgate at centre back, and then I put Gareth Barry at left back because Alan Wright got injured. Merson on the right, Alan Thompson on the left, George Boateng in CDM.
Nice.
And I moved Carboni into Cam, and I gave David Connolly his debut with Dion. And I managed to win the game 3-1. Dion Dublin scored a hat trick.
Get 20 goals already.
Dion's on fire.
Just to go back, Nate, if that is right, just googled Sunderland's just to see 1999 we played 6 games in August.
That's mental, like.
I know.
Absolutely. So it would have been right. 7th of August, 10th, 14th, 21st, 25th, and then the 29th. Sorry.
Jesus. Gary McAllister scored for Coventry. I forgot they had Robbie Keane like that season. Like, I don't know why, but for some reason I thought he was at Inter Milan that year, but I'd seen Robbie Keane. I was like, oh, no.
It was the season after, because I think Robbie Keane signed for Coventry in like the September, October sort of time.
Yeah.
And then it was the following summer he moved to Inter and played like 6 games before he was loaned to Leeds.
Unreal. Absolutely unreal. Third game of the season, away at Everton. I had Mark Delaney came back from injury, so Mark Delaney went in at right back.
Reisinger after a win.
Oh mate, he's like he played like that many games and he was just his fitness was gone. Like,
fair enough, you've played 40 games already in the Total Cup.
So Mark Delaney got in. David May got his debut. He started at centre half with Gareth Southgate. Gareth Barry stayed at left back. Merson, Boateng, Hendry, and Carboni in the midfield. Put Hendry on the left wing just to give Thompson a bit of a break. And to be fair to him, Lee Hendry did all right at left wing. Dion Dublin and Julian Joachim up front. And Julian Joachim is garbage. Utter garbage. I brought Alan Wright on. Mark Draper came off the bench. Najwan Girab or something like that. Some like Israeli left back or something. I'd never heard of him, but he was all right. I beat them 1-0. Carbone scored.
Good result.
Some of the Everton players in that squad, like Everton had signed Keith Gillespie, so I don't know how that one slipped us, but they'd signed Keith Gillespie from Blackburn. Mark Pembridge got man of the match. What a player he was. Just notable things from that game. Carbone bagged his fiftieth Premier League goal in the Premier League or something like that. That's what it came up as. And then Kevin Keegan after that game, because Kevin Keegan was at the game watching, obviously Kevin Keegan's England manager. And he came out in the press saying that he was considering selecting Merson, Dublin and David May for his first squad. So my reply in the press was, yeah, you should pick all three, to be honest with you.
To be fair, and Dion, the rate he's scoring, eh?
I know.
Oh, you can't stop.
I tell you,
do you know in the 06 save?
Yes.
A database. I was just thinking there, Dion. I played Norwich the other day, and he was left wing back against us.
Okay, because on the early Champ Mans, he was always striker, centre back.
Yeah. Like,
If you click on him in the 06 database, he's got green circles in centre half, cam, and forward. they played 3-5-2 against us, and he was wing back, so Dion couldn't do it all.
Joachim would have been one of the first players I flogged if I was in charge of Villa.
Seeing his pace and he can play out right wing, so I thought when Mercy's getting a bit knackered, I'll stretch the midfield out. And I'll put Joachim on the wing and we'll just get balls in and pace on the sides. And it works later on. For the fourth league game, notable scores. Sunderland beat Leeds 4-2. The reason why I put that down is because Kevin Phillips scored 4 and Johnny Woodgate scored 2. I was like, I'm not going to not mention that.
Did you not go in for Woodgate? Do you not have a little dinks to see how much it cost?
I wanted to, but the prospect of signing David May was just like, I just thought, no, I'm signing David May. Played Southampton, beat them 2-1. Goals from brace from Gustavo Bartelt, some Uruguayan striker. I can't remember that. Because at first I thought it was like, maybe it's like Angel or something, and like they haven't like changed his name or something. So I like looked for him and no, he's at River Plate. So I have no idea who Gustavo Bartelt was, but like scored 2, so I'm not complaining. next game I played when I use, I'll find the table, I've got to say, everywhere, man. Fifth league game of the season at home to Watford, and Watford played a 5-3-2 with Robert Page at centre half and Gifton Noel Williams up front. So I thought, I'm in for a game here. Unchanged 11, and I beat them 2-0. Gareth Barry and Dion Dublin scored again. So I've gone, after getting beat off Tottenham, I went 4 games unbeaten, and I'm now 4th in the league. So
is that 4 wins?
Four wins and a loss, yeah.
It's a good start, that.
Gustavo Bartelt was loaned from Roma to Aston Villa in 2000 and played no games.
Well, he's played one for me and he's got a brace.
Played 15 for Roma and scored no goals. So they loaned him to Villa. They didn't play.
Wow. Fantastic. So I know that he's waiting in anticipation to see what was waiting for Kev Keegan's first England squad. And he didn't pick any of them. He picked Gareth Barry and Gareth Southgate instead. So I'll give you the quick England squad. 3 goalkeepers of Nigel Martin, David Seaman and David James. So I was chuffed for J-Mo, because he's done all right, J-Mo. So I was like, he deserves his call. Defenders, Johnny Woodgate, Rio Ferdinand, Wes Brown, Saul Campbell, Gareth Southgate, Andy Hinchcliffe got in the England squad. Gary Neville, Phil Neville and Graham Lasseau. Midfielders, Paul Scholes, Nicky Butt, Lee Bowyer, Gareth Barry, David Beckham, Kieran Dyer and Nick Barmby. And 4 strikers, Andy Cole, Alan Shearer, Michael Owen and Robbie Fowler. So I immediately called...
Dion's got some work there, like...
Oh, I immediately went into the press and called for Keegan to get sacked. The bit where, like you can type.
Yeah.
Press asked me a question, like, thoughts on why David May and Dion Dublin have been omitted from the England squad. So instead of, like, doing the usual comments that it gives you, I clicked on other, and I must have typed a massive essay up. Like, I was like, what am I doing this for? Because no one else is watching it. But basically called for Keegan's head. Like, just get rid of him. I mean, he dropped Steve McManaman as well.
Like, I'm surprised he didn't go in for McManaman, to be fair.
No. He's at Madrid. He's not going to want to swap the warm climates of Madrid for freezing cold Birmingham.
You're not on the transfer list?
It starts quite a lot. Other news, Martin O'Neill got sacked on the 31st of August from Leicester City. They're bottom of the league. And Bury's Neil Warnock is the favourite for the job. So, nice. Yeah, so I'm doing all right. To be honest with you, they only want a top half finish and I'm 4th. So if I can keep it going, then who knows? Might get Villa in the Champions League.
Massive.
What is your end goal? Like, what do you want to do?
I want to win the FA Cup.
Nice.
I want to win the FA Cup with Villa. I want to win a trophy with Villa. I just want...
Got to shoot for one. Do the FA Cup. Like, mine's get them back in La Liga. Jersey's win a title, but he's got, like, a title winning side, to be fair.
I know.
FA Cup, that'd be decent.
I want to win the FA Cup with Villa. I want Dion to lift the cup. So I can hound him on Twitter.
I'm not just gonna stop once if I win Serie A. It's got to be like
I'm not either. I'm just saying what's like that because you read a lot of forums and they've got a goal. Like there was the one that you sent us, Ronaldo, to win the Champions League. They'll have a goal first. Mine's like I'm not gonna get in the Liga and be like, oh, I'm bidding this off.
No.
But that is my goal for this story.
Yeah, I want to win the FA Cup. I want to win the FA Cup.
Oh, spot on. So finally, it feels like a pure relief finally being able to talk about it and how you've been getting on. Like we listeners, we literally talk about Football Manager every day. We've all had to start like alternative saves just so we have something current to talk about because we can't talk about this on the daily. So this is.
I've been holding in that David May signing for ages.
I've been holding it. I've given Depot. I was like, oh, they're going to people love this. Like,
you've done well to keep that a secret.
Yeah,
I was planning.
Also, we're going to... Anybody listening, if you've got Football Manager and stuff and you've never had a go at like downloading a retro database or anything. If you go to fmscout.com, there's absolutely loads. There's loads of different ones people take the time to put together for different different versions of the game. It's well worth a look. And I think, I know me and Dill are definitely going to have a go. Are you doing it as well, Nath? Like posting on the stories forum?
Yeah, I'll have to get it all like properly sorted.
So eventually, like hopefully just a couple of days after this drops, if not, it will be coming. But we're all having a go at like typing it up and putting them into stories. To if you go onto fmscout.com, they've got a like a stories section, which is just like a forum where people post different tales of how they've got on. Because I've said all along, like playing Football Manager is unreal, but hearing how other people are getting on, I find just as fun, to be honest.
It's mint. It's absolutely mint.
Everybody does it differently, and like everybody has like different little their own thing, you know what I mean? Different little niche that they're like doing. So no, this will be good. I've got as far as November, I think, on my Palmer save. I've wrote a bit more in depth for September, October, because we obviously was able to fill a lot with pre-season before then. So
we'll revisit
in a couple of weeks, yeah.
And, absolutely,
definitely.
Like, if anyone else has got a Football Manager save, hit us up with it, like photos and that on like social media and that. And
yeah,
it's good to see what everyone else is doing, like, because obviously it's in lockdown, and if you're not at work,
then you should be playing Football Manager.
You should be playing Football Manager. If you're not playing Football Manager, you should be listening to the podcast, really.
Yeah.
my boss rang me for a catch up before, and I was like, he was like, what are you doing? And I was like, just walking the dog loads. No, I'm fine. Well, 80% of my time is footing around. I didn't want to say it to him. Supposed to be an adult around my boss. So I was like, I'm at depth on it.
Honestly, I'm supposed to be spare at work. So like, if other people need a hand, I can just jump in the van from the depot and then go and help them. And I'm like, one of the lads is sick, so I'm doing his run. But like, in my bag for work, I've got Championship Manager 2003-2004, so I can like load it up and install it into the computer in the office. But like, I can't because I'm still having to go to do proper work. I'm absolutely good because I want to play that at work. But honestly, I just live for it. I love Football Manager.
Oh, it's absolutely class. Like FM20 was the first new one I'd bought since 2008 when that came out. And yeah. I 12 years not playing like any of the newer ones. And then when I downloaded it last year, I didn't particularly enjoy it at first. It wasn't until us three done that save where we were just like chatting the whole time through it. And it's just totally like ignited the flame.
You can listen to our Championship Manager and Football Manager episode as well. That's in season one.
Yeah. No, but right. Spot on. So next up, we've got the quiz, won't it? It'll be the quiz after this.
Yes,
it is.
So at time of recording, in a couple of days' time, we're doing the Zoom quiz with a friend of the show, Kev Clark, is taking part in. I'll be hosting. I've got it already. A few surprises and stuff. prizes as well.
Nice. Hey, let's wait for that.
So we're recording it on a Saturday evening. We're all having a drink as well. So it could end up a bit slurring words and it'll be a good laugh. But that's the end of season two quiz, which will end up being episode four of season three.
I've already apologised for that.
In a couple of weeks' time, we'll pick up where we left off on the Football Manager prawn sandwich adventure.
Absolutely.
All right.
Absolutely.
What song should we end on with? What song should we go out with? You just said adventure, so should I find like a Lord of the Rings theme or something to go out on?
I was going to say, if it was 1999-2000, when we'd done that drinking game in lockdown, S Club 7 Reach popped up twice and got Del absolutely steamed.
Yeah, I'm game for that
Fong
one.
Fong Soul Brother, there was the FIFA 99 song.
Well, go for that then.
Yeah?
Nah, Fatboy Slim. Yeah.
Love it.
Yeah.
Right.
Love it.
So, right, well, see you next week, everyone.
See you next week.
Did a bit.
Bye.
Right about now, the Funk Soul Brother. Check it out now, the Funk Soul Brother. Right about now. the Funk Soul Brother. Check it out now, the Funk Soul Brother. Right about now, the Funk Soul Brother. Check it out now, the Funk Soul Brother. Right about now, the Funk Soul Brother. Right about now, about now, about now, about now.
How's the bacon, did you say?
That's it, Stuta! Oh, what a fantastic hit! Roy Keane on Haaland.
Here's Sancho.
Aguero!